So this device is a smart cane, so it's an assistive device for the visually impaired. So last year, I was at my friend's house one day when I had a chance encounter with her visually impaired grandmother, Lorraine, and she was bumping into a bunch of things around the house, and that's when I realized that the white cane that the visually impaired currently use is only a stick, and it hasn't been updated since 1921.
And so 15-year-old Ria Karamenshi decided that she should be the one to update it.
Person who was really passionate about technology and inspired me to incorporate object detection capabilities, GPS navigation, and also artificial intelligence.
And she's been getting expert advice at the DMZ Base Camp, a summer program for innovative young minds.
We bring them in, we help them out with developing their skill sets, getting them to be able to market it and actually accelerate the product or the business itself.
How is this cane going to be different from ones that exist right now?
Yeah, so existing white canes are actually only a stick that you have to feel around to detect an object. So what this will do is if anything is in front of a person's path from knee to head level, the ultrasonic sensor detects something and it vibrates to let them know if it's something there so they can avoid any potential injuries.
And there's a part two for this too, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're looking at sort of a prototype of an app that will exist.
Yeah.
And this will connect to the cane.
Mm-hmm.
And what will it be able to do?
So this app is actually an integration of the computer vision functionality. So actually using artificial intelligence to detect objects around you and describe what they are.
The app will work with the cane to also get people around the city.
Mm-hmm. So let's say if you wanted to go to the CN Tower, it compiles all those directions to the app and sends them over to the cane. So let's say if you had to turn left, it would vibrate once, and then turn right, it would vibrate twice.
Amazing.
Thank you so much.
Can I see the cane?
Yeah, for sure.
And today, she was able to present her idea to officials from the CNIB, who support any technology that could potentially assist the visually impaired. And to Ria's delight, they were optimistic about her idea.
And I think something like this is the difference between, you know, being shut in at home or maybe just going to areas that you're familiar with to exploration and going to places that you're not familiar with.
Well, Ria says hearing that is motivation for her to keep going with her idea. She hopes to actually have it on the market by the end of 2019. In Toronto, Audra Brown, City News.